So my name is Professor Mead. I'm the Eileen M. Fall Professor in Cancer Research here at Northwestern, and I'm in four departments, including chemistry, neurobiology and physiology, biochemistry and molecular and cell biology, radiology, and I'm the director of the Center for Advanced Molecular Imaging. I was recruited here from Caltech to design an imaging center and be part of the Chemistry of Life Processes Institute, which is housed in Silverman Hall. And the idea was to create an environment where a molecular imaging center with 13 different modalities would be surrounded by the basic sciences at every level. So engineers, chemists, and biologists are moving into this building, and the imaging center itself is surrounded by those on all levels. And the ability to produce a screen and build a screen of this magnitude, which is entirely unique, there is nothing else like it, takes teamwork. I met Matt McCroy. I noticed very quickly that he was responsive to my visions of how a space could be created where you could have both education and research that overlap in real time.
There are 25 screens, each one 46 inches for the diagonal. And each one of these displays is a full HD 1920 by 1080. So if you do the math, it turns out we have almost 52 million pixels. And to put that into perspective, a digital IMAX theater has about 8 million pixels. And this is a much smaller physical space, so the pixel density is very high on this wall. These displays are actually commercial displays, so you wouldn't be able to walk into a Best Buy and pick one up. They're a little bit more expensive, and part of the reason for that is they use a different kind of 3D technology, and it's the kind of technology that the movie theaters use, so you can use the really cheap glasses.
You know, we look at the structure on small computers like that, and typically what you do is you just keep rotating it around and kind of slabbing through it to get a feel for the 3D. People you're working with, collaborators who don't really kind of have a sense for the idea that proteins are three-dimensional, this is a fabulous way to introduce that.
When the center is fully operational, we will have 13 different imaging modalities in-house. Because the questions we ask, typically these modalities have advantages and disadvantages, and each one has their special advantage. So we wanted to house them all in one space.
One of our goals is to be able to take the data as it comes off of some of our imaging devices and update it on the wall in real time. So as the data is coming off, it's just streaming onto the wall, and we can see the volumetric data kind of build as it's being scanned.
So having all the modalities close by, having the expertise from engineering, chemistry, and biology in one space is entirely unique. As a matter of fact, there is nothing like CAMI anywhere in North America, and it is for the entire Chicago area. We look forward to reaching across the aisle to all the sister institutions in the Chicago area. And once they get a hold of this and they see what Matt can do with some of their images, that is a selfish reason for people to play together. And that's what we've tried to design. And what I mean by selfish is that they are really going to have something that is uniquely going to solve a problem that they could do in no other way. And when they see that kind of resource, they are drawn to it.